It's AumSum time.
What if coronavirus disappeared?
Huh? Wow, that would be awesome.
Wow, AumSum. Firstly, the current depression-filled atmosphere will be replaced with positive smiles all around. Secondly, people who have been under lockdown for months will surely jump with excitement. Thirdly, months of lockdown has given people a lot of time to think about life in general. Hopefully, after lockdown, we will have a much more cheerful, responsible, and fitter society. Fourthly, schools and industries will open up. People will start going to jobs. The economy will start roaring again. Fifthly, health infrastructure around the world has been under severe stress. If coronavirus disappears, doctors and nurses will heave a sigh of relief. Lastly, public health will be given a lot of importance worldwide so that such pandemics do not occur again. On the flip side, pollution levels might start rising again. What if face masks were made compulsory?
Then I will change my profession. I will become a face mask designer.
Wow, AumSum. With everybody wearing face masks, contagious diseases may soon fade away worldwide. But on the flip side, firstly, face mask factories will start popping up all around the world. Secondly, face masks will slowly become a fashion accessory. People will start wearing designer face masks. Thirdly, with face masks compulsory, lipstick and lip balm industry will probably face gloomy times. Fourthly, dating with face masks will probably be awkward to start with, but people will slowly but surely get used to it. Lastly, with face masks compulsory and beards and mustaches no longer visible, men will probably stop caring whether to shave or not. On a serious note, people will have to clean their face masks regularly, else the entire process will be futile. What if social distancing is made permanent worldwide?
Permanent? No ways! I'm ready to join the protests!
Wow, AumSum. Social distancing is deliberately increasing the physical space between people to avoid spreading illness. If social distancing was made permanent worldwide, firstly, social distancing and dating do not go well together. The way people date will change forever. Secondly, social distancing will change the way games like football, rugby, cricket, etc. are played. Players will need to attend coaching classes all over again. Thirdly, more and more cameras will be installed in public places to enforce social distancing. Privacy will take a back seat. Lastly, rock concerts, marathons, festivals will have to issue new guidelines to remain within the gambit of law. But on the flip side, with social distancing enforced, contagious diseases may soon fade away worldwide. What is a coronavirus?
It is an alien which is haunting all of us.
Oh, AumSum. Coronaviruses are a large family of viruses. They're found in animals as well as humans. Some of them are known to infect people and cause illnesses such as Middle East Respiratory Syndrome, as in MERS, and Severe Acute Respiratory Syndrome, as in SARS. Novel coronavirus, or 2019-nCoV, is a new strain of coronavirus which was first detected in Wuhan, China in December 2019. The disease caused by novel coronavirus is named as COVID-19. Here, CO and VI are taken from the word coronavirus, while D stands for disease and 19 stands for year 2019. Some people might suffer from mild symptoms like runny nose, sore throat, cough, and fever because of the virus, while some might experience severe symptoms leading to pneumonia. For some people, this disease has also proven to be fatal. Research is still on, but the animal source of the novel coronavirus has not yet been identified. Symptoms of coronavirus, COVID-19. Novel coronavirus, or 2019 nCoV, is a new strain of coronavirus which was first detected in Wuhan, China in December 2019. The disease caused by novel coronavirus is named as COVID-19. Fever, tiredness, and dry cough are the most common symptoms of COVID-19. Some infected people may also experience aches and pains, nasal congestion, runny nose, sore throat, or diarrhea. Symptoms of COVID-19 are usually mild and begin gradually. Also, surprisingly, some infected people don't even develop symptoms and don't feel unwell. It is estimated that more than 80% of people recover without the need of special treatment. But it is also estimated that 1 out of 6 people suffering from COVID-19 will become seriously ill and will develop difficulty breathing. Also, people with underlying medical problems like high blood pressure, heart problems, or diabetes, as well as older people, are more likely to develop serious illness. It is advised by WHO that people with fever, cough, and difficulty breathing should seek medical attention. Protective measures against coronavirus, COVID-19. Washing hands frequently. Washing your hands with an alcohol-based sanitizer kills viruses and thus stops the spread of COVID-19. Maintaining social distancing. When someone infected with COVID-19 coughs or sneezes, they spray small liquid droplets from their nose or mouth, which may contain the virus. Social distancing is deliberately increasing the physical space between people to avoid spreading illness. Avoid touching your eyes, nose, and mouth. As our hands touch many surfaces, we may accidentally pick viruses from there. Now, if we touch our eyes, nose, or mouth, we may transfer the virus. The virus can enter our body from there and get us infected. Practice respiratory hygiene. An infected person can help protect people around him if he practices respiratory hygiene, like covering his mouth and nose with his bent elbow while coughing or sneezing. Should everyone wear masks?
I have no idea.
WHO recommends masks to be worn by the following people. People who are either sick or showing symptoms. Also, by those who are caring for people suspected of having coronavirus. As per WHO, medical masks should be reserved for healthcare workers. WHO is not recommending masks for public for the following reasons. Firstly, people might use masks which are contaminated by other people's coughs and sneezes. Secondly, wearing masks might offer people a false sense of security. Thirdly, as per WHO, social distancing and frequent hand washing are more effective. Now, as per the European Center for Disease Prevention and Control, if non-surgical face masks are worn by public, then they might help control infection by those who are affected with coronavirus, but do not show any symptoms yet. This will prove to be useful in busy and closed spaces like shopping malls, grocery stores, etc. Why is it hard to cure common cold?
'Cause common cold wears an invisibility cloak.
No. Firstly, there are more than 200 viruses which cause common cold. Now, developing 200 vaccines for 200 viruses is impractical. Secondly, developing a single vaccine for all 200 viruses is proving to be complex, time-consuming, and expensive, as a lot of R&D is required. Thirdly, we can't make antivirals to kill viruses, just like we make antibiotics to kill bacteria. Why? Because antibiotics attack the bacteria's protective cell walls. But as viruses don't have any cell wall, antivirals will be useless. However, there might be some good news. Now, a virus survives in a human body by hijacking a protein found in human cells. Researchers have developed a compound which inhibits the virus from doing so. But as the compound targets human cells, more research is needed to test its safety. What is sinusitis?
It is a collection of chocolate pastries.
In our skull bones, there are hollow spaces which open into the nasal cavity. These are called paranasal sinuses or just sinuses. There are 4 types of sinuses: maxillary, ethmoid, sphenoid, and frontal. All of them produce mucus, helping moisten the inhaled air. Now, sinusitis refers to a condition in which one or more sinuses get inflamed, creating pain or a headache. There are various causes of sinusitis. Firstly, infection caused due to harmful viruses, bacteria, and fungi. Secondly, anatomical deformities in which the sinus openings are too small, making it difficult to drain the excess mucus. As a result, it becomes an ideal environment for illness-causing germs. Lastly, smoke or allergens like pollen, dust, etc. can also lead to sinusitis. Now, acute sinusitis usually lasts up to 4 weeks. Subacute sinusitis persists for 4 to 12 weeks. Chronic sinusitis lasts for more than 12 weeks. Recurrent sinusitis occurs when there are 3 or more episodes of sinusitis within 1 year.